T. Donovan.
How's it going?
Well, it's going great. And this is a great place you've got here, too. I love all this fantastic movie stuff about. I saw Tango and Cash on the shelf over there, one of my personal faves. Although, I'll take Stallone in just about anything.
It's a video store. So how can I help you?
Well, other way around, because I'm wondering if you'd at all be interested in making a television commercial to advertise this little gold mine. I'm a producer slash director slash sales manager of a cable company, and I'd like to get my cameras in here and shoot this venue, get the word out.
We just don't have the money for that kind of stuff. It's just a small store.
Sure, I mean, that's okay. But, I mean, think about it. For just a small investment, because I understand you're a small business, I can turn this business into a video cash cow, all right? And I've got just the guy in mind for this spot, okay? I mean, he's a real artist. And I'm thinking movies, you know, and music, and how about a video party, huh? Stuff going on in the aisles, cases, whatever. You know, some of that's up to you. I'll give you some creative control. And the guy I've got in mind to rock this thing, he's a lot of fun. His name is Jumpin' Johnny.
No thanks, man. Like I said, not really interested.
Maybe is there a manager I could speak with? Because I can, before we run the numbers.
I'm the assistant manager.
Yeah, like a main manager for the details.
We only have assistant managers here. It's a team effort.
I've got an assistant, that's... Whatever. You know what? Thanks for your time, dude. I'll let you get back to your video stuff. Have a great day!
Welcome to tape 2 of Jacob Stern's Do Bet, and yet you can't. You want to have a first meeting with this new company, and you want them to buy your product, and you want it.
Got what you need to build things.
Now, of course,
tree forts, houses.
That's the number one goal. But how do we achieve that goal? That's the big question.
Absolutely.
Eye contact, my friend.
Absolutely, Jacob. Absolutely. And that's gonna. I'm gonna use that today at the hardware store. I'm gonna use it. I'm gonna make it work. You bet. Yes, I can.
Your product you're selling with even greater and better things, whether it be dressing nicer than the next man, wearing a nice suit, a nice tie, color coordination, the firm handshake.
Jacob wouldn't do that, and I shouldn't do it. Help me, Jake. Get me out of this funk, man. I need to hit one over the fence. I got it. Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Well, let me begin by saying I love your store. I love it. I've been to a lot of hardware stores, but yours is
tops for sure. You've got everything. I mean, if you want to build a tree fort or a fancy doghouse, anything, you've got everything. Well done, sir.
Who in the hell are you, boy?
Yeah, I'm BT Donovan, as I with Watch First Cable. Chuck, and it's your lucky day, Chuck, because I've got a local celebrity lined up to record a jingle and do a TV commercial for your store.
No, 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 no. I thought I smelled a salesman. No, no, not interested. Thank you. We're fine. We've been the Yellow Pages for 10 years, my friend. We're fine.
Yellow Pages, Chuck. I can turn your cold hard ice picks into cold hard cash. Chuck, I've done it. I've done it before. I can... Chuck, is this your family? A beautiful family. Chuck.
Jacob Stern says you can lead a horse to water, but there's nothing you can do if they're not thirsty or if there is no water. I'm not gonna beat myself up about it. Jacob wouldn't, and I need to hit one over the wall. I need to drive the crowd.
You will see that the studies and the statistics that we have shown have only proven that my theories stand true.
Yes, I
now, you can look back at other motivational speakers. Yeah, I don't care who you look at. You can look at your Zig Ziglars and your Tony Robbins and anybody else that you want to look at, but I'm telling you, my theory stands true.
Help me, Jacob.
Now, their books
help me, Jacob.
Flow.
I need one. I need a win. I need a mark
and
in the win
I'm
column today.
Maintaining that
definitely
my
do
that.
I don't know
that
if
are
I have time.
Success. I've sold more copies of my tape booklets than anyone else has. And it's because
time to get
the final
to
step in this whole
possibility.
Positive attitude, and that is
Akasaka Sushi. Akasaka Sushi.
You bet. Yes, I can.
Do not have time.
Did you do it? Did you say
time
it?
Time for a call, though. Time for a cold
it,
call.
You don't believe it. You bet. Yes, I can. Say it and believe it. Say it and believe it. Now.
I love my call.
Hello. Welcome, Akasaka Sushi. Store hour, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. open. And 4 p.m. to 10 p.m. open, too. Thank you. Yes, now you leave message. Thank you.
Hello. Hello there. Everyone down there at Akasaka Sushi. BT Donovan here with Watch First Cable calling, and...
This message is for a Mr. Kazumi, I believe. Mr. Kazumi, you are in some big-time luck today
because my tomorrow, Wednesday, just opened wide. So let's say three-ish? Good? Good. Great. Looking forward to talking some advertising with you and...
Getting the old sushi ball rolling. You don't know me. We haven't met.
BT Donovan with Watch First Cable.
I grew up in the Midwest. I was born in the Midwest. A lot of boys growing up, I think they kind of dream about being, a firefighter or a police officer. Best situation, you're both. You stop the crime and you run and you put out a fire and you're a hero to different groups of people. I wasn't one of those boys. I always wanted to work with my hands, clay, ceramics, things like that. And now I'm making local TV commercials, and so I keep getting closer. I guess the turning point was probably 10th grade in high school, and I really wanted to take ceramics too, and class was full and teacher couldn't get me in even though I'd done really well in ceramics 1, and I ended up in a TV production class. and I liked it. I didn't expect to like it, and I was pretty good at it. I ended up making a commercial for the girls' swim team that year, and they went to states, and I can't take the credit, but it was, I know they all liked it, and they all asked for copies of it. I get my motivation, I guess, from a lot of different sources, but the last few years, it's been, I don't know if you mind a little plug, but it's been this guy here, Jacob Stearns. He's a motivational speaker, and he's motivated me time and time again. I guess this is a newer series of his called You Bet, and Yes You Can. The series before this was a 4-tape series, and tape 3 and 4 really focused on what Jacob Stearns calls LTD, living the dream. And that's just this idea that we've all got dreams, and some of them even like a dream you have at night, and you wake up and you write down this crazy dream about how you were, you know, on a horse and you were in another country and you met someone who was only half human. And his idea is that no matter what your dream is, you know, make it a reality.
Look at my box cover, look me square in the eye, and say to yourself, you bet, and yes, I can. That's not me you're looking at on that box cover, that's you. Because you are the next Jacob Stern.
We can do this.
I didn't get to the top
you can.
Of my
I can.
Mountain.
You can. I can. You can. I can. You bet. All right. Sushi, sushi, sushi. It's Japanese. It's raw fish. Some people like it.
You want to have a first meeting with this new company and you want them to buy your product and you want it to buy it in large quantities. Now, of course, that's the number one goal. But how do we achieve that goal? That's the big question. Eye contact, my friends. Eye contact. You bet. And yes, you can. You make it through the secretary into the big boss's office. You sit down on that stool in front of his desk and you look him square in the eye and you say, my name is, insert name here.
We weren't Amish, we weren't, I don't think we were like part of any organized religion, but it was a strict household, and one of the rules was when we'd owned something for over 2 or 3 years, we would try and sell it. Just because it had served its purpose, we figured, and someone else probably needed it, and we needed something else. And my dad was the king of that. I'd gotten something when I was about 7, just this you know, teddy bear thing from my mom, and she knew I liked teddy bears. I don't care if people know that. And so she got me this, and you know, 2 or 3 years went by, and you know, dad's thing, we got to sell it. And he went out in the corner, he sold it to someone, and I only got like a buck for it. So, I mean, it would have been different if I'd gotten 5 or 10. I think it would have helped with, I don't know, the emotional thing, but I didn't make much.
Hi there, BT Donovan.
Yes, okay.
Yep, I've got a 3 o'clock with the owner, Mr. Kazumi.
Oh, yes, okay.
Ah. Very good, sir. Great. That's good. Shot in worse conditions. Great. Come on. 1 second. Hello. Let's do this.
Well, thanks for meeting with me on such short notice, fellas. I know how busy you are with all this sushi stuff. Let me begin by saying, you've got the best sushi in town. And don't I know it, okay?
Okay.
Which brings me to the reason why I'm here. Now, as I've already said, you've got a great product. Your reputation speaks for itself. When you guys do your sushi, it's hot. Everybody's talking, saying they haven't had real sushi since they took a vacation on the West Coast. So now I know you guys know your sushi, all right? Okay? Seriously, though, this thing's taken off, and I just want to be there to help you with the ride. So, what have you been doing to advertise Akasaka Sushi thus far? For advertising, what are you doing?
We don't know. What are you talking about?
You know, promo stuff, pushing your product, pens, pencils, t-shirts, mugs, that things, you know, things of that nature.
Phone book?
Phone book? Yellow pages? Are you guys kidding me, right? I mean, when someone looks up sushi restaurant in the phone book, the chance of them picking Akasaka Sushi, that's not too favorable. You've got the best sushi in town, so why not corner the market? Take it to the next level. Let the whole city know, maybe more, that you've got the most authentic, exciting sushi food cuisine the Midwest has ever seen. All right?
All right, okay. Okay.
Let me tell you how you do that, gentlemen. The way to do that, gentlemen, is by taking a more aggressive approach to your marketing. You need to open your minds to new mediums such as radio and cable TV.
We don't know how to do that.
Yeah, well, lucky for you fellas, I do know how to do, all right? I've been kind of in the advertising biz for a while, all right? I've been to meetings, I've taken classes, I know it works, and I know it hurts. Now, I'm a full-time producer slash director slash sales manager of a local cable company. I can turn your limp green seaweed into cold hard cash using the airwaves. Going into people's homes with the TV. The TV.
All right.
TV.
Okay, yeah. Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Yeah. 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 Well, as I was saying to Mr. Kazumi last Wednesday, Mr.
They call him Watanabe.
They call me Lonesome Cat.
Lonesome Cat.
Well, Mr. Lonesome Cat, I've got some ideas and concepts for Akasaka advertising. But the thing we need to do first is get a catchy jingle and then saturate the airwaves with it by applying it to a television commercial. And then boom, I can turn your small investment into a tenfold increase in business for you. So let's get this puppy rolling, huh? Tell you what, I got some papers you're gonna need to sign. Which is a short form. I'm gonna run to the head a second and you can look over the papers and sign away. Think it over if you need to. Don't think you will need to. Kind of a no-brainer, I think. But there you go. Just need the old John Hancock. Be right back.
Me do. Don't talk anymore. You fired tomorrow.
Oh, all right. That's what I like to see. It's like everything's in order here. Guess what, fellas? I got a little surprise for you. I've got the perfect artist in mind for the jingle, and I think he's a fun character for a TV spot as well. Very likable. Bit of a local celeb. His name is Jumpin' Johnny Blues.
One, two, one, two, three. Oh, you can play that guitar. You can play the fiddle. Play that old washboard with a checkerboard in the middle. Well, you can play that pedal steel or slide on that trombone. Or you can whistle Dixie Dear while you dance the old ham bone. You can fish a fat crawdad and fry him in a pan. Or you can pluck on that banjo and join a Dixie band. Well, you can eat on that gumbo, as I so often do. Or you can ride that grand showboat if you're jumping Johnny Blues. Hey, that's me, y'all. That was a little Southern style. I'm fixing to take 10, so hold on to your hot wings, y'all. Thanks.
There he is! Howdy, Jeffrey! Johnny, how you doing?
Not bad. Well, this band's hot. Where'd you find these fellas?
It's your band, man. You brought them.
You know, I thought I recognized them. These SOBs follow me everywhere.
Yeah. Great set, Johnny. Crowd loves you.
Yeah, all seven of those people are really having themselves a ball out there.
Look, it's a weeknight. You always pull it in on the weekends.
Fair enough. Well, I'll be damned.
Doc, Dragon Colt, hold the Colt.
Excuse me, Jumpin' Johnny. Hi, sorry, excuse me, BT Donovan here. I'm a huge fan, it was a great set.
Oh, thank you, kind sir, until you're a smart young man.
I've actually got a little business proposition for you, if you're interested.
Oh, well, I'll write it in.
I'd like you to consider, I'd like to hire you to compose and perform a commercial jingle and star in a TV commercial. How's that strike you?
TV commercial? Like television?
Yeah, TV. It's for a local sushi restaurant.
Who the hell is Sushi?
No, it's pronounced sushi the way I said it. It's a Japanese way of preparing fish and seafood. That's not important right now.
Japanese fish? Kind of reminds me of an old boy back home named Buster. He got one of them ponds and waterfalls in his backyard. Got a bunch of them orange oriental catfish swimming around in them. I always tell him he better keep his eyes on me because them fish look like good eating.
Right, you probably mean koi fish. That's you're close though. I mean, that's super close. Maybe the easiest thing is just think of sushi as fancy Japanese food, Johnny. What I'm looking for is a 30-second jingle that we can use in radio and TV spots. Just think about it. I mean, you write a song, you shoot with me and my crew for a day, the next thing you know, boom! You're sitting at home, you're collecting a check, and you're watching yourself on the TV. And Johnny, think what it could do for your career.
Sounds interesting. Let me think about this. Hey, Doc, you got a pencil and a pen back there I can steal from you, real quick? Well, tell you what, I'm gonna give you my name and number.
Great. And I will keep that, under lock and key. I won't be giving that out, Johnny. Right.
Well, give me a call with the specifics, and maybe we can do this thing.
Great. Absolutely.
Right. Nice meeting you, BB.
It's BT. It's short for Barry Terrence.
BT, BB, whatever. Why don't you try this one on the side? Well, you can get your best chopsticks and eat up on some fish. Try that Japan food, cause I'm jumping Johnny Blues. How about that?
Nice.
How does that fit you?
Not bad.
Looks good on you.
Yeah, thank you.
All right.
Looks like I came to the right man. Have a great, break a leg.
Hey, a leg be fine, just can't afford to break a string. What brought me from the South to the Midwest? Well, I can tell you it definitely wasn't the weather. The word snow in the South is secret talk for drugs. And the only drugs I need is the Jack, the Johnny, and the Jimmy. Yep, I guess I'm just fixing to bring my Creole-style blues to all y'all Yankees up in here. Why, sushi restaurant? Well, first of all, hell. Extra cash never hurt me none, and this BT fella, he sounded like he knew what he was doing. I'd love to hear my Southern style pushing some Oriental food on the TV. I'm just happy to play my music to the people. I don't care if, shoot, it's on the TV, in a bar, or on Mars. This is what I do, y'all. Well, that's a funny story. I guess as a youngster, I was just known for jumping over stuff. I done jumped a cow. I done jumped a plow. I done jumped a one-story house. I guess I was just a jumping fool. After that, I started playing the blues. It was a guitar and a fiddle with a catfish on the griddle. Real home style. Ever since then, I've been known as Jumpin' Johnny Blues. And that story is true. Don't believe me? Try this one on for size. I was born in New Orleans with a wood spoon in my mouth. Shotgun shack outside town, a true son of the South. My daddy drove an ice truck, me mammy did the wash. Sound chicken, chicken like sound chicken, chicken like smoke that fatty hog. I made a four-string guitar by the time that I was five. It was tough old days way back then, just good to be alive. Well, I knew someday I'd make it, cause I told my trusty dog. All I do is chase swine, and I asked for the pig, but I wound up with hog. Believe me now?
Brad, when we get to the... Don't use up too much tape. I've only got one extra.
Come on, it's just like cops.
Listen, and Mike, when we get to the sushi place, you guys need to know a couple things about sushi so you know what kind of genre we're working in. It's Japanese, so it's, I mean, if you just think general, Asian Oriental food, it's a bunch of raw fish. We don't have to eat any of it while we're there. We get in, we get out, we shoot the thing. Some things to remember. There's going to be some people. There's some. I'm serious. If you don't run out the whole thing, I've got one extra T120, and if we burn through that, then we're already over budget. Brad, you're in charge of the camera. Mike, you run the lights.
Okay.
If that switches, if during the shoot I need to switch that, you've got to be ready to roll with it, because that's how this, you don't know what's going to happen. Mike, I need you to take this seriously. You're not even, I tell you what, I didn't ask Brad to bring you, and you're here as a favor, okay? This is a learning, this is the school of life for you, and I'm expecting you to take it with some degree of seriousness. Turn the camera off, Brad.
This camera's old.
Turn the camera off, Brad. It's older than some cameras, but you can't, you gotta stay within a budget. So what a lot of people don't realize, as a producer and director, you gotta weigh quality versus quantity. That's Jacob Stern's, tape 3. You guys should borrow the tapes from me if you want. Tape 3, cue to cue. Quality versus quantity, how do you balance it? Tape 4 gets into that a little deeper. It's a tightrope, and I run a tight ship. Brad knows that. Mike, you're gonna learn that, and you're gonna know it by the end of the day. Brad, I'm gonna need you to pull out the map at some point, because I took a wrong turn somewhere. Okay, we are... Okay, now this looks familiar. One thing you gotta do, Mike, as a producer and a director, is you gotta delegate responsibilities while you're on a shoot. I can't do everything, and I learned that the hard way, which is when I brought Brad onto my crew. I started him off at minimum wage. As his responsibilities increased, so did his salary. You're doing this as
an... I don't get paid.
I let you stay in my basement. I let you stay in my basement rent-free.
You live with your parents.
I'm sorry, what?
I thought you lived with his parents.
Talk to me when you're talked to. Answer when you're given a question, Mike. All right, I need to get in my zone, so I need a little silence. We're getting close. You guys, if you need to get in a zone, you can take this time to do that as well. You know what I mean when I say get into a zone, Mike?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Well, I can't teach that. You'll find it. Find your zone. I hope this goes all right.
Sushi is blowing up all over the country, period. You know, it's, if you will, the cuisine of the elite. So, you know, it's blowing up on the coast, so I figured why not bring it to the Midwest and blow that up. People are interested in sushi. You know, people are interested in stuff that's different, and sushi qualifies. You know, so I figure why not make a great commercial to really entice people to try out this great, exciting new food? And what better way to do it than to bring in a local celeb to really push the product? And that's what I've done here. I've taken one great thing and then a second great thing, and I put them together, and I hope that the end result is like a third, bigger and better great thing.
All right. Let's go, Brett. Mr. Kazumi, it's a big day. Big day here. Got everybody. This is BT Donovan. I'm with Watch First Cable, and we're gonna be shooting a commercial today. And if you don't mind, you may be on camera, but the good news is you'll be on TV. You also might get some free sushi out of it, okay? Yeah. So we're just gonna be setting some stuff up, go ahead about your business, and I'll let you know if I've got some special requests. Honey, get the camera down there. All right, this is the layout of the shop. We got the four booths over there. We got the two tables in the middle. This is the counter that we're on. We've got the beads down at the end, and those are one of the most important things to get. Anything that really just lets it know this is an Asian restaurant, there's Asian food here of a lot of different varieties. Once the song starts, there's gonna be a line of dancing. It's gonna do a figure eight around the tables, and that's the biggest, that's kind of, it's what's called the money shot. Folks, I'm just gonna be getting a shot of the lantern. You might be in this shot, but no guarantees. In the shot, and we're coming off the lantern, dropping down, and there's the customers. You're in the shot. All right, do it again. All right, we're in the lantern. We're dropping off the lantern, coming down. Oh wait, hold on. There's an Asian picture on the wall. Go with that. Okay, good. Once more for safety.
Okay,
we just need to get a shot of you guys eating. So just eat like you'd eat if you were eating. Okay, tell me when you're rolling.
How do you focus this one again?
It's an autofocus. It's a new machine. You don't have to do it manually.
It's so blurry.
There we go. And we're rolling. So let's bring in the agua. Bring in the water. Go. Rolling. Rolling. And here comes the water. And again. That's, great, okay, cut. So let's get, what we're gonna do, if you guys can all, just gonna say sake together, you take the glasses, and we're gonna roll on that.
One, two, three, go.
Sake!
No, we gotta, that's a Johnny thing. We got the lanterns, we got the bead shot, we got the, yeah, that Johnny's
Hello.
Here.
Hello.
Yep, come on in, Johnny. Don't be shy.
This a place?
Yeah, everybody. This is Jumpin' Johnny Blues. Jumpin' Johnny Blues.
That's me.
Yep. A lot of you probably.
That story is true.
He'll tell you a story later, and that'll retroactively
one or two
work. Okay. First thing, we've got all right. This song recorded. I want to get you jumping in with this group.
That's the sushi hot. The one we did. Okay.
Yep.
All right.
Yep.
All right.
We laid that. Okay, everybody, this is fun. Once the music starts, we're into it. This is Jumpin' Johnny. Make him dance. Okay, it's dance music.
Yep.
Okay.
If you like sushi food,
are we ready?
Just let him know. Let everybody know about your sushi food.
Okay, we're rolling. Yeah. And action. Okay, good, we got the light on, thank you. We're into this, all right, let's do it.
Do I need to move the ladder?
Leave the ladder there, we'll take it out in post.
Yeah.
Sushi, sake, high,
yep.
Sushi, good. Sake to me, I'll sake to you.
Yeah.
Feeling good, and you like that sushi food. Now you can say, sushi, sake, high, sushi, good.
You know what? Just let me do it.
I'll sock it to you. Feeling good. And you know what sock it do.
Good. Good. We're coming up
now
to the end.
Say, sushi, sake, hot, huh? Sushi good. You sake to me, I'll sake to you. Feeling good. And you.
That is a wrap. Right? We done? We got it?
Sushi. Sake.
Sushi, sake, ha, sushi, good. You sake to me, I'll sake to you. Feeling good, and you like that sushi food.
Sushi food.
Now you can say, sushi, sake, ha, sushi, good. You sake to me, I'll sake to you.
Sake to you.
Feeling good, and you know what sake do. Now you can say, sushi, sake, ha, sushi, good. You sake to me, I'll sake to you. Feeling good, and you like that sushi food.
Now you can say,
hey, this guy's good.
Akasaka Sushi, serving authentic sushi food for the Grand Rapids area, located on 28th Street in Cascade.
Business is booming. Now many people come now. Cowboys, urban cowboys. Thank you, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
So, as you can see, I mean, you guys aren't idiots. I knew that right away. And as I've already stated, this little honey may be the ticket to a one-way ride to success for you guys. Okay? On that note, no pun intended, and you'll understand why that's funny in just a second. Are we ready? Are we good? Well, gentlemen. Mr. Carnivale, Mr. Hanuxala, please welcome Mr. Squeaky, the recorder playing clown.
Hi, fellas. I take it apart and put it back together. We chop up a cow and put it on a platter. My recorder sings a familiar tune. Best steak in town. Now that's great food.
He knows this. Let's do that again. Let's do it again.
I take it apart.
No, just just the flute part.
Oh.
You can see the potentials there.
Oh.
We got a deal?
Besides playing the blues, I guess one of my favorite pastimes is fishing. I'd love to do me some fishing, especially in noodling. Reminds me of old boy back home named Terry Don. He done noodled himself up a 100-pound catfish. And, oh man, kind of look like my third wife, whiskers and all. Oh boy, I've been married so many times, I forget them all. Yeah, my first wife, she was a real sweetheart, real, real dear to my heart. I lost her. We were down there in Florida playing some shows. We took one of them rides through the Everglades on one of them fancy boats. I told the driver to stop so I could do some fishing. When we were fixing to leave, she was leaning her hands back in that those big propeller fan things in the back. And when that driver kicked up that motor, them propellers took her arms clean off at the elbow. She never did really quite recover after that. My second wife, oh boy, she just done ate herself dead. A real porker she was. When they found her, she had a piece of chili meat hanging out of her mouth, and some chicken had been festering in her fatty folds. Took them a big old crane just to get her out of that double wide. Whew, it was sad. And my third wife, I don't know what the hell I was thinking. I was drinking pretty heavy back in those days. She had a beard like a pirate and a face like a buzzard. A real hag she was. I just gone and slipped out the back door when she wasn't looking. Man, she was uglier than a two-headed mule on his last leg. Last I heard, she was doing donkey shows in Tijuana and going home with the donkey.
We're having fun! Oh!
Cut. How about some
Everybody eat!
Alright. We need silence.
Slippity, slippity, slippity blue!
Ha 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 ha!